After 4 weeks of Advent preparation for the birth of our Savior, Jesus Christ, the Christmas season is finally here. Just as Mary and Joseph anticipated and prepared for Jesus' birth, we prepare to celebrate our Christmas traditions with family and friends. Our preparations included planning our Christmas menus and shopping for the gifts and groceries for our loved ones in anticipation of gathering together. During our gatherings with family and friends, encourage your children to ask about the traditions that were practiced by their ancestors. Encourage your guests to reminisce about their Christmas traditions so that they can be passed on to the future generations. Remember to give thanks to the past generations for these wonderful memories. The prophet Isaiah proclaimed, "For Zion's sake, I will not be silent. For Jerusalem's sake, I will not be quiet. Until her vindication shines forth like the dawn and her victory like a burning bush." Isaiah would not be quiet in his time. We should not be quiet in our time. We are so blessed to live in a country where we don't have to be silent. We can wish everyone to meet Merry Christmas with great joy. We can publicly profess our Catholic faith and openly celebrate the birth of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Several years ago, I started reading my Bible. The more I read, the more I began to read it. It quickly became a daily routine. I always skipped the theologies in Matthew's Gospel because I thought that they were dry and boring. But thanks to one of my scripture professors at Notre Dame Seminary, I can truly appreciate the Gospel of Matthew because they tell about Jesus' family tree. We just listened about the Gospel that Deacon Jim Roney proclaimed today. All of Jesus' ancestors were sinners, and some were even great sinners. We are all sinners, and our ancestors were too. We need to admit our sins, learn from them, be truly sorry for them, and try not to sin again. It doesn't matter what our ancestors did or what we have done. Jesus Christ came, became a man as the Lord to save all the sinners. This should prove to us that we need Jesus Christ to be our Savior. Let us take Jesus into our lives and more forward so that we may draw nearer and nearer to God. Remember that every time we greet and we congratulate someone that Merry Christmas, It is a chance for us to wish them hope, love, joy, and peace. This is the fullness of its meaning. Our responsorial psalm said, "Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord." Let us sing the goodness of the Lord in our lives and throughout this Christmas season. The other day, I was walking along the sidewalk. I greeted a mother and her little child. The child knew that Christmas was all about and wished me Merry Christmas. The impact that the wish had inspired me and to remember all that we celebrate today. So let our reading today be full of meaning of Christ. The birth of Jesus on Christmas morning allows the mystery of our faith to take the next step in living our faith. I pray that our Merry Christmas today may have the same impact that the child had on me. May Christ's coming today change our hearts and the hearts of those that you greet this Christmas season. This Christmas message expresses my heart's desire that you and your family experience a deeper awareness of Christ's love for you as we joyfully celebrate his birth. I am pleased that your journey to Bethlehem brings you to our parish church. On behalf of the priests, deacons, parish staff, and myself, we extend to you and your family a blessed Merry Christmas. May Christ shower upon the blessing upon you and your family in this coming New Year.